The following program is brought to you by Total Security Services International, Homeland Security, Disaster Preparedness, Emergency Management. Total Security Services International. When the protectors need protecting, they call on TSSI.
Here at the gate where the Amsterdam flight was due in on December 25th, 2009. My name is Jeff Beatty, and I'll be your guide as we talk about this incident. I'm a former Delta Force officer, former special agent of the FBI advising the National Hostage Rescue Team, and a former CIA counterterrorism officer. And whether you're a security or transportation professional, an airline passenger, or just a concerned citizen, it's important to understand what happened and what almost happened on December 25th.
Hello. We're here today to talk about the December 25th, 2009 attempted terror attack on Delta Airlines Flight 253. On that day, it's alleged that 23-year-old Umar Farouk Abdulmutallab was traveling from Amsterdam to Detroit on Delta Flight 253. There were 279 passengers and 11 crew on board when he tried to destroy the plane by injecting chemicals into a 2.2-pound package of explosives that was concealed in his underwear. Fortunately, the explosion went low order, causing a fire. Passengers and crew subdued the attacker and extinguished the flames. The plane then went on to land safely at Detroit. Officials in Yemen say Abdulmutallab may have met with a radical American Yemeni cleric linked to al-Qaeda and the alleged Fort Hood shooter as part of his preparations for the failed attack. The Deputy Prime Minister of Yemen said that the 23-year-old met with al-Qaeda members in the remote Yemeni province of Shabwa before the attack, a place he said he believed was connected to radical cleric Anwar al-Awlaki. The U.S. learned of the airline bomb suspect's extremist ties while he was in the air. U.S. officials learned of intelligence linking the man to extremists, again while he was en route from Amsterdam to Detroit. Authorities actually planned to question the Nigerian when the plane landed, showing officials came close to uncovering the Christmas Day plot despite failures at other levels. Senior law enforcement officials said if intelligence officials had learned of the information earlier, Abdulmutallab could have been interrogated and searched before he got on the flight from Amsterdam. But it was unclear if the intelligence was strong enough to cause Dutch officials to prevent the man from boarding the plane. Officials in Detroit were prepared to look at him in secondary inspection. They could have made a decision on whether to stop him from getting on the plane. A federal database noted State Department concerns that Abdulmutallab may have been involved with extremism in Yemen. Let's talk a little bit about some analysis summary points. What went wrong? PETN and TATP were explosives involved. TATP is not detectable by many bomb-sniffing dogs due to poor training requirements. We also did not act on the father's and other reports that there might be something wrong about this individual. We were guilty of U.S. government arrogance that we would get it right, that we would be able to analyze our way into identifying him as a problem. United States analysis has failed numerous times. Why do we still have faith in it? Then when he landed, we treated him as a criminal and not a combatant. We read him his rights and lost an intelligence opportunity. What went right can be summed up in one word: the passengers. Let's talk about some general recommendations. We cannot rely on a failed analytical process. Someone in the U.S. government has to be held accountable when we fail like this. What we need to do going forward is to act on a single bit of derogatory information and interview, search, screen, deny boarding, and apprehend, if appropriate, on a single piece of information. And then we need to treat these individuals as combatants, That's what they call themselves. Why should we call them anything different? Now, these summary comments just touch the surface. More detail would not be appropriate for a public forum. If you have a need to address this threat, call on TSSI. We have a demonstrated track record that shows we know how to win against terrorism.